Alrighty. Well, this here is going to be the Gibbering Prophet fight, the champion version. So, version 3.0. Let me show you what I got here. I've had this set up before, so some of you might be familiar with it. Just kind of a range heavy. You know, maybe. Yeah, I'll leave it the way it is. It's more versatile. Oh, and to let everybody know. Yes, I use an inventory / trinket mod. Mainly because I don't want to have the inventory full pop up after every single battle, because the way the devs balance this game was a little bit loot heavy. The loot to inventory ratio is a little off, I guess that'd be an explanation. I mean, I just wanna run the dungeon and not have to file bankruptcy after every curio or every battle, so that's the only reason I have it in there. There's also a trinket mod in there, but I basically had to have this in there in order to have this in here. It's just the way it was set up. So all this is just a bonus. But let me get back up, guys, here. But pretty much same thing. No. Before I forget. I'll swap that out since I don't need that anymore. And I don't know if this guy's immune to stun or not, so. -75, and I'm pretty sure the boss has a dodge rating, so I'll go ahead and keep that in here. But again, I don't know if, fact, this is going to be kind of a risky strategy, but I'm just going to go ahead and assume that the boss is highly resistant, if not immune to stun, so I'll go ahead and put judgment in there instead. And I doubt I'll need that. I don't know how resistant he is to debuffs, but just to be on the safe side, I'll go ahead and throw that in there. But I guess since I don't need a scout anymore, I'll pull that out. I'm guessing it's going to be impossible to surprise him. Maybe not. I'll leave that in there. That'll reduce our chance. No, never mind. Never mind. I'll shut up. But that's what I got, so. Hope this turns out well. Here we go.
The madman hides there, behind the pews, spouting his mindless.
Hey, what a waste that was. Hell, if I'd have known he was gonna go first regardless, I wouldn't bother putting out speed stuff on him. Ah!
In Radiance, may we find victory. Impressive.
Here we go. She's back. And she's probably gonna be spending most of her time healing. Spot. Nothing else I can do.
Dodge off.
Guess that was actually a good idea to put some heals on her.
Passion is a rarity in the fevered pitch of battle.
Cool, both of them dodged. There. That came at a good time. Awesome.
Did he foresee his own demise?
I cannot.
So long as he remains dead. A trifling victory, but a victory nonetheless.
Yippers. Alrighty, well, this here is gonna be the Swine God battle. And made a lot of stupid mistakes getting to this point, so because of that, a lot of these guys are pretty well stressed out. But otherwise, let me show you what I got. And this probably isn't the world's greatest party comp. Pretty sure the big guy up front's gonna be immune to stun. Oh yeah. So no point having that in there. I guess I'll have that instead. I'm not sure how tough they are against. Basically, a 75% chance of that actually kicking in. Alright, I'll go ahead and leave him the way he is. And yes, I'm using inventory mod, but I mainly do that just so I'm not having a go through a frickin' full inventory and having to sit here and decide what I want to keep and what I want to throw away after every single battle or carryo. So it's mainly for reasons of convenience. It also came with the trinket mod, but all this is just a bonus. I mean, I had to have the trinket mod in order to use the inventory mod. It's just how it works. Have her in position too. Yeah, this one. And because we're all scouted now, I'll go and pull these out of them, increase their speed a little bit. This guy here, from what I've read, he can still stun the little pig that I'll be fighting without damaging him, so because of that, the big guy won't retaliate. and you won't be all surprised, and so I'll go ahead and pull that out of her. And plus, her stress is already getting kind of up there. I mean, hell, if I don't... I just found a hidden use for having an inventory mod. Made me carry some extra trinkets with me. And just swap them in and out. Yeah, that's... Oh, and, my arbalist also has the worries. So, she's gonna take extra stress. And I'm not sure they got a dodge rating. And, yes, I'm using a cheat sheet right now. Believe it or not, I found this on accident. I didn't intend to come on this page here, but... And so, because of that, let me go on this guy here. Basically just going to be the buff-o-matic. Okay, but otherwise it looks like I'm good to go, so here we go.
It is a travesty. A blundering mountain of hatred.
All focused on the big
and rage.
Instead. And this is why I have to have the arbalest in here. Dodged it. How about that? And I believe she's going to be the big damage dealer. I'll put it on her. Not a moment too soon. Hey, resisted it. buffed.
The blood quickens. Vision. The end approaches.
Man. Crappy RNG. That's two crits in a roll from him. And hell, I wouldn't even call it a crit. I'm only dealt 3 points of damage. Dodged them both. Yay, dodged them. Out of those. I don't really want to move them up front. Gotta keep them down.
Inspiration and improvement. Thank you.
Okay, note to self, don't bring them up front.
Dizzying blow to body and brain.
You know, for something that only deals 2 points of damage, I wouldn't exactly call it a crit. I mean, strictly speaking, it is, but I mean, 2 points of damage.
Devastating blow.
Dodge off. That hurt.
A hand's breadth from becoming unwound.
Set the mark on her.
Compassion is a rarity in the fevered pitch of battle.
Oh, hell, they're still marked. Back at death's door again. Alright, he's down.
Horrible in death. Like what action cannot come soon enough.
Surprised she hasn't died yet. Dodge is gonna have to be taken off.
Such a terrible assault cannot be left unanswered. Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles.
Oh boy, that was a close one. It's to the Abbey and Tavern with you guys. Oh, that's getting sold. As is that one.
Alright. So we are good to go.
Squirming, contorting, and ever expanding.
Every turn, it
this horror must be unmade.
Won't do much damage, so I'll just go. And these two here are the healers. Again, they do share a health pool, so there goes all my hard work. Done. It's maybe more important to get the dog. Yeah, this is a bad set right here. She dodged it. Resisted. So why can't I use? Just because wore off.
Sedated.
Oh, great.
Precision and power.
Came at a good time.
A devastating blow.
Uh.
brilliant confluence of skill and purpose. Is a small consolation, given the implications of its terrible existence.
You made a good call this having this ability in here. This expedition at least promises success. Most of the damage. But otherwise, wish me luck.
Twisted and maniacal, a slathering testament to the powers of corruption.
Well, she doesn't have proc, she only has a dodge rating. So a marker. Back and forth between taking her dodge off and party healing. Well, there went all my hard work. That's kind of cool. I like that. Damn it.
Sir, surgical precision.
In you go.
Got it.
Leave her corpse.
Just barely.
Spores she spawned. The bigger the beast, the greater the glory.
Yeah, I'll be selling those.